and spit upon our names, and the ravens back over the fields of ash will whisper our tales of shame. So let it all.
Some heart on a battered and barren road. Together, though we're worlds apart, in unison bear the load. But we will never hold a weight if we cannot communicate. Pass it on, not yet gone. And we will ever isolate if we cannot communicate.
Communicate. Good morning, friends, and welcome to another stream. I'm Andrew, also known as Tanatos. Hello, good morning. How's everybody doing today? This is my painting stream, where on weekday mornings I go online and I paint some minis on stream. I've been working on some Crisis Protocol minis. If you were watching yesterday, I made some good progress on these folks. The first three minis are mostly done. I got some arid grass from the store. I'm going to try gluing that on the bases to make the bases look a little more interesting. And I'm not completely happy with Captain Marvel's face, so there's a little bit of work to be done there, but I'm not going to do that today. Now that I've completed the first three minis, for the most part, today I am going to build some more minis. So, I have the instruction booklet, and I am looking through the sprues to find the next three that we're constructing. So the next three are Doc Ock, which is, not that sprue's used, huh? Give me a sec, folks. Just need to find. There he is. Sorry. There. Doc Ock. Black Widow. Okay. Is one of the smaller sprues. Sorry, my desk is a bit of a mess, folks. And I seem to have moved some stuff, and I don't know where I moved them to. I thought I had all the sprues together here. Yep. And Iron Man. This one, Iron Man? Has an Iron Man-y sort of look, but it could be yeah, this is not Iron Man. It's Ultron. Where did I put the rest of the sprues? These are bases. Excellent. Today's off to a wonderful start, chat. Excellent, excellent. That's kind of alarming that I can't find any of the rest of the minis. Oh, well, let's get started on Doc Ock and then I'll look later for the rest of everybody. So, go to Zoom Cam. Here we are on Zoom Cam, where I have all my various implements. So what we discovered last week when we were building the first three of these folks is that they're a little bit more fiddly than I am used to in the models that I've been building in the past. They just have a lot of different bits. This guy's not so bad. What we discovered in some of the other folks was that they had arms that were in two different pieces. Here you can see that his human arms are folded on his chest like that, so they're not so much of a bother. But his robotic arms look like they come in three pieces each. So they've got the long tentacle bit. They've got this little bit here, and then they've got the claw bit. So they're going to be a little bit annoying to construct. Okay, well, we'll start with the torso. So we'll snoop those bits off. And then these do require a little bit of cleanup. So we need to clean up where the sprue was connected, but we also need to sort of look for any flash where during the molding process, stuff got out. It looked pretty good. There's a tiny bit of flash here and there, but they're in pretty good shape. I can't tell if this is intended to be a molded edge here, or if it's flash coming out. Definitely need to trim this here. I don't know if you recall when I was constructing the other pieces, they didn't fit perfectly together, and I ended up having to patch them before I could prime them. Pretty good. So, glue those bits together. Really perplexed as to where the rest of the sprues have gone. Scooging out on the edges. It's pretty good. Now the relaxing bit of building models. The holding in place. I view this as a form of meditation. You have to hold them in place for a little while, and here I'm trying to apply a certain degree of pressure because I don't want too much in the way of gaps. Very relaxing. Yes, so restful. Good morning, lobster. There. A little bit of a gap here. So hold it for a little bit longer. Enjoy some coffee. So how's everybody been? Outside of my stream, it has been pleasantly busy at Battleground. We've had the pre-release for the new Magic set, which is the D&D, the Adventures in the Forgotten Realms Magic set. And it is pretty popular, and actually pretty cool. I was concerned. I think a lot of people were concerned about mixing the properties. But Wizards has done a good job. I mean, A, they didn't take themselves too seriously. And B, they looked at D&D and sort of said, what are the tropes that people tend to joke about with D&D? Let's make sure we get all of those into this set. So it's got like the classic villain creatures. It's got a roper, it's got a beholder, it's got a mind flayer. It's got a flumph, which isn't really a bad guy, but it's got dragons, of course. And then it's got, this is, I'm just gonna stick his head on next. It's got some well-known characters from the R.L. Stine books. Too bad they didn't do any Dragonlance, but they've got some well-known characters, and they've got, oh, I put way too much glue in there. It's coming out all around his neck. It's okay. Let's see if I can wick some of that away. The glue getting into the crevices and ruining the sculpt. Anyhow, yeah, the D&D magic set is really fun and folks are enjoying it. Right, next, his arms and his feet. His human arms, that is to say. So I'm quite pleased with the new set, and it's been a lot of fun in the store. And outside of Battleground, I have been playing a fair amount of Sea of Thieves. And when I say a fair amount, I mean 4 to 6 hours a day. Maybe tomorrow I'll play more Sea of Thieves on stream. We'll see. So I am conflicted on Sea of Thieves. Obviously I'm enjoying it. Otherwise I wouldn't be playing it as much as I am. But it has a fundamental flaw that seems to be baked into the game, which is that it is a player versus player game. That is just a core mechanic. And I don't enjoy PvP. I don't enjoy playing against random people on the internet. This is why I don't play any of the Call of Duty or games like that. I just don't enjoy it. This is why when I was playing Destiny, I never did any of the Iron Banner stuff. I hate playing against people. Hate it. I hate it. And there's no option to turn that off in Sea of Thieves. Just, you are inevitably going to have to play against people. And it ruins the game for me. Like, I love the treasure hunting, I love the sailing around, I love customizing my boat, and even hanging out with friends. All of that is great. It's a fun world. They have sort of narrative quests you can do. But then you've also got just roving bands of jerks who who get their enjoyment from sinking your ship and stealing your stuff. And there's no way to not have that. So like 80 to 90% of the time, I'm having a great time. And then the rest of it, the constantly looking over your shoulder, checking to see if somebody's sailing up on you. Duh, it's awful. So, I don't know. I might uninstall it. I'm having a lot of fun, but I'm also, it's giving me fits. So some of the other figures, I had some trouble attaching some of the pieces. This one is being much more cooperative. Lobster, I uninstalled the sound alert application from my stream, so I don't know why it still has the ability to redeem stream points for sounds that no longer work. Not only does the thing not work, but I actually removed it completely, and it's still there. Yeah. The small frustrations that I have to live with. All right, so we've got everything except for his robot arms, his robot fists. Human arms on there. Oh, I just pulled off his leg. Oh, 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 oh. Okay. It's okay, folks. Let's try to get the arms to go on fully. So now, I have to construct some arms. Interesting. Someday the change will come. While we let him dry, here's the instructions for building the arms. So two of them come in multiple segments that need to be glued together and then add a bit. Or three of them do. One of them is just a single segment with a claw on the end. And these claws are made from two pieces. I think the trick here is going to be finding which segments go with which segments, because they're not numbered. Like, Games Workshop numbers the pieces, so you know you're getting the correct piece. Here I just have to go from the illustration. So we've got, well, they do have numbers on the sprue, but the instruction book doesn't have numbers. That's very foolish. Anyways, are they numbered in the order in which you assemble? One, two. No, they are not. All right, that's fine. All right. Are they identical? Not quite, but almost. All right. So one of these end pieces has a male as opposed to a female end there. And that's the first piece that I'm looking for. So let's get that. And then that marries to one of these that has a female end instead of a male end. That is this one here. And then I do think that the open claws are identical. There's two of those. Grab one of those. Oops. And then we'll do some cleaning up. But coffee. Well, you know what? I can drink some coffee for you. Oh, coffee. Ah, delicious. Cha-cha-cha-cha-cha-cha. Worse by trying to turn the flash off. So I do have a decision to make with this guy when it comes to painting him. Am I going to attempt to paint the arms? Am I just going to paint them silver? Which I think is probably the easier way to go. Or am I going to attempt to do some sort of NMM, non-metallic metal effect, which is more in keeping with what I tend to do on my stream, which is pushing my boundaries, but also probably will be more of a challenge for me. I mean, definitely will be more of a challenge. And I have not gotten NMM to look good yet. Dust around here. Okay. So these claws have little extra bits here, which are just injection sites for the molding, I guess. We'll just tear those off. And then
clean this up. I might do a little bit of a glow on the claws here. Just a small, subtle hint of a glow. Because they've got the sort of lens here in the center of the claw. I might paint that red and then have just a little bit of a red glow on the interior of the claw. Just because it would be something fun to play with. Okay, let's put this arm together. Do this if I can avoid it. Patience, not one of my strong suits, but if I try and glue this onto him immediately, it's going to cause problems. So I'm probably going to have to assemble the arms and then take a short break from assembly on this figure while I wait for those bonds to form.
Okay. Next arm. Next one, step five arm, is just one long piece. So that's easier. Right? That is this one here, I think. Yes. Trimming. Glue some paper towel bits to my file. Excellent job. So far, so good. Nope, there we go. Okay. I was like, did my glue get plugged? But then, no. I'm getting it. Okay. I've done there, but it is what it is. Maybe I can, I don't know. Now that I've glued it on, I don't want to mess with it too much. Maybe I can mess with it a little bit before I prime it. But you
Okay. Next arm. So we're up to step 6 and step 7. Step 6 is build the small claws, the closed claws. The illustration is not super clear, but we've got these here and that there. I think this is another of these cases where these sprues have extra bits. You remember how I had extra heads on Captain Marvel? It's not even like they have options. It's just extra bits. Very weird. Feel enormous and stubby. Good morning, Pi! How are you today? I hope you're feeling better than you were earlier in the week. I hope your body has stopped betraying you. I am putting together some minis so that I can paint them. Look at this, chat. There's a lot of glue that came out of the join on this side. You can see all that glistening there. That's glue. On this side, there's a gap. Oh well. Is not perfect system. There's one little claw. Let's make another. So Jules, I've just been talking about how frustrated I am with Sea of Thieves, that it is such a fun, gorgeous game marred by the presence of PvP and constantly getting sunk by evil people. Oh, Pi, you've got new emotes! I remember seeing the horny Pi emote in your Discord. Looks a lot nicer now. Is the other one Bitchy Cat? Yeah, the pie face does look nice. Well, that's exciting. New emotes. Wow. Folks, I hope you'll tune in this afternoon for more Stardew Valley with Pie. And chill farm times. Yeah, they really did. That's gorgeous. You've seen my emote, right? It's kind of unclear what it's intended to be, but it's supposed to be a brush that is blooming as leaves coming out of it. You know what I am looking forward to? And it's going to be a little while before it becomes reality. There is a game called Palia that is in early access right now. I don't have access to it because I haven't made it into the pre-alpha. But it is a Mamorpuga farming game. So sort of Stardew Valley, but also sort of World of Warcraft. It looks so cute. And that is definitely something that I know I'm going to be spending a lot of time playing with when it does finally arrive. All right, so I've got two more arms to construct here. And because the parts don't really have an indication of what they are, I'm just gonna have to hope that I get the right one with the right one. Oh, okay. One of these has a circular end, or a semicircular end. One of them has sort of triangular end. Unclear. I really wish that the makers of Crisis Protocol had put numbers on the illustration so that I could tell what is supposed to go with what. I mean, I figure if I get it wrong, it's not a big deal. But I'm a stickler for doing things the way instructions tell me to do them. Palia is probably a year out, because they're in pre-alpha now, and they've only got, like, a couple thousand playtesters. But it looks gorgeous. And when it arrives, I will probably be streaming some Palia. just hanging out, doing some farming, some fishing, maybe a little adventuring, building my house, all that sort of stuff. All right, let's see. Does this go to this? Not quite. All right. Try this. Does that go with that? Oh, that's a much better fit. Okay. Come on. Come on, Groove. Holding pieces together. Little claws that I just built. Too much glue. Excellent. Almost done, folks. Well, with this first model for the day. All right. Toss that sprue. process of elimination, these pieces must go together. Let those set. Have some coffee. And I need to see if I can find. The rest of the sprues. I don't know where I hid them. So give me a moment, chat. I'm going to take a short break while I hunt for sprues. Be right back.
Galleys with a stink of decay, stamped down under boots of the company. Slave spirit, propagate and obey. Trust up in the hog ties of industry.
If you produce and produce to consume,
it's all you know now.
Suffering lung as you breathe in the fumes.
Still here they go, selling you the sky and the stars. Always gotta push it to.
Friends,
a Amanda says, let's go to IKEA and get a new chair. Yes, let's do that. Since I'm having to hammer this chair back together between scenes. All right, so I found the remaining sprues. Let's go back to Zoom Cam. Here we are. And these are Iron Man and Black Widow. So let's assemble those. She has two of this arm. Weird. So weird. That's fine. Alright. So, I think Black Widow is pretty straightforward. Torso first. Down on the ground and flip your hair. Such a poser. We did watch the Black Widow movie on Sunday, my family, and it was fine. It was not the greatest Marvel movie by a wide margin. Not the worst Marvel movie. Sort of a middle-of-the-road Marvel movie. But it had some good bits. Largely any time that Florence Pugh and David Harbour were on screen. The rest of it, pretty skippable. That for a moment while it solidifies. I hope they make a Red Guardian figure for Crisis Protocol. I feel like it would sell well. Though largely Crisis Protocol is more based on comic books than the MCU. It uses characters popularized by the cinematic universe, but the aesthetic is very much the comic book look. All right. Interesting. So this recommends attaching her right leg first, and then building her right arm, and then doing the left arm and leg and head as a separate piece. So let's get her right leg. Wouldn't do to put her left leg on her right side. this holster that goes on her right leg there. This is the gun and holster. And her right arm is the arm that is in two pieces. Oh no, they're both in two pieces. Her right arm is... This is her right arm, here. And this hand, of which I've got two copies, is her right hand. My fingers are almost cramping up, having to deal with holding such tiny pieces. I like how they hid the join in her wrist gun thing. I don't know what you call that, a wrist bandolier? Doesn't look right. There we go. Attach the gun in its holster. Where I think tweezers wouldn't really work, but fingers are too big. Yeah. Perfect. Okay, so far so good. Next up, build her other arm.
Step out into the sunlight, emerging from the past.
glued it to myself. Perfect. There we go. Going in perfectly. There we go. Got it. That'll do. Okay. And then her other leg and her head. And then she'll be done. Screw point right at her temple. That's annoying. I've got 20 minutes. Well, I've got half an hour left. Do you think I can build Iron Man in half an hour? We shall see. How annoying this is. Giant ass sprue contact right on the side of her head there. This could be worse, going into her forehead. It's not terrible. Okay. He's done. Well, aside from the base. Let's stick Doc Ock's arms on. Oh man, it's like a puzzle. Look at this. Each of them has a different shape. Oh, okay. Okay. this song goes there. One. This goes here. Yeah. Gotta get an amen, now, brothers and sisters. Amen. Gotta get an amen, now, instead of that sleep. Two more. I'm doing this right, chat. Okay. I've only got one space left. That's two figures done. Iron Man. Start with the torso again. Yep, step one is torso. Cool. Mm-hmm. Iron Man should be fun to paint. If there's anything I should do non-metallic metal on, it's Iron Man. Try and get those reflections and specular highlights on his red and yellow body. Progress, chat. We're making progress.
Wow, there were a lot of coffee grounds at the bottom of my coffee mug. Oh my goodness. gritty and sandy. Ah. Okay. I may have put too much coffee in my coffee filter this morning, because apparently it overflowed into the coffee. I mean, whatever. It's coffee. Gritty and Sandy, the Sludge Twins. Yeah. Yum. Okay. Next up. Oh, man. This is annoying. His legs come in three pieces. First, I have to build his thighs, and then I attach his the lower legs to them. Why you gotta be like this? Ah. Very cleverly, one of the thighs has a male and female on it, and the other is male and male. So that'll help me to determine which goes with which. Oh no, it lies! Chat, it lies! The illustration is a lie! No! Okay. Which of these goes with which of these? No, let's just cut all four of them out. I really wish they'd put the numbers in the instructions. Sorry, choking on coffee grounds. Well, luckily Amanda's still home, so if I start choking live on stream, she can run in here and give me the Heimlich. I'd prefer it didn't come to that, though. Yeah, Amanda, did you get to see the new pie emotes. So cool. Pie, I'm so proud of you. I really should not go late today if I can avoid it, because Amanda needs to lunch early so that she can get to work early. She has computer maintenance she needs to undertake before she can open the branch. Amanda does not want to monetize her read-aloud stream. It just runs into copyright issues. It's easier for her if she doesn't. But it would be cool for her to have emotes, because she needs a Clara Says Goodnight emote. If we were ever to have merch, we would have Clara Says Goodnight t-shirts. Yeah, same pie. My emote is from my brother, who is legit a good artist. Same for my my new avatar. I say new, it's about a month old now. Yeah, that would be cool if we had affiliate level follower emotes. Okay. Now, I've got 4 thigh pieces that in theory go together. All right, this is pretty obvious. These two do not go together. So these two must go together. I think you qualify for instant approval emotes because you're awesome, Pi. I'm sure there's an algorithm that knows how awesome you are. Ah! Oh my god, so much glue on my fingers. Thighs done. Now let's find his legs. Yeah.
Almost lost that one.
After I've built his legs, build his arms. And then I think his head is two pieces as well, because he's got his visor. Let's see here. All right, so these round bits here are on the outside. So if that's the outside, then that means this is his right leg, which means it would have to go with this, because that's a right foot. Chat. Walk the garden, breathe the scent of life. Take this moment like that. Comfort in my tiny paradise. There we go. There we go. Like that. It's like a puzzle. Some of this extra glue. There we go. Okay. Whew. Leg's done. Now his head is only a single piece. His arms are three pieces, though. Because they've got... No, wait. One, two... One of them is four pieces, and one of them is three pieces. Because they've got these epaulets, these shoulder pieces here, that are a separate bit. So let's see. Okay, those are the four parts of this arm. I do not think I am going to finish Iron Man. What I'll probably have to do is finish him off stream. So I'm going to have to take a break to have some lunch. We got pretty close. Because I've got one more arm that's in three pieces, and then I've got his head. Wrapping things up pretty soon. So I'll finish this arm. And then I'll probably end my stream. Thank you so much, everybody, for hanging out with me. Who's it? Good active chat today. Had some fun. Does that look right to you? That looks wrong to me. This arm is not supposed to be bent, it's supposed to be out straight. It must go like that. Okay. Today I will take these folks to Battleground and prime them. Tomorrow on stream, I will most likely... That just looks wrong. What the heck is going on with this arm? I guess... tomorrow I'll most likely be playing Sea of Thieves on stream. Though I might start painting these folks. I hope folks will, if you are not at work as Amanda will be, tune in for Insidious Pi's That is all wrong. Is this the wrong hand? Got the hand right. That elbow looks wrong, though. Yeah, this is the wrong forearm. Good job, me. This one. So in about 1 hour at 1 p.m. Eastern over at twitch.tv/insidiouspi, Pi will be playing some Stardew Valley, which is very chill and definitely worth watching. And then at 10 p.m. tonight, Amanda will be reading more of Swallowdale. They're going to summit the mountain that they have been climbing. So that should be very cool. And I'll be back tomorrow morning with something. I don't know exactly what yet. That went together a little better. I think I'm going to glue this arm on to his torso first and then attach the shoulder piece. And then I'm going to call this for today. Or I'm just going to throw things on the floor. See if I can find that arm. Where on earth did it go? There it is. Okay. So thank you for joining me, folks. This has been a lot of fun. I'm gonna finish building this Iron Man off stream, just so that I can have it done. That's right. Looks rightish, sort of. All right, cool. So I will do the other arm and head and glue his legs on off stream so that I can prime him at work today and start painting him tomorrow or Friday. In the meantime, I hope everybody has a pleasant day. Pi, I'll see you over in your chat at 1 o'clock. And be excellent to each other, friends, and enjoy whatever art it is you choose to do. I'll see you again soon. Bye, everybody.